Good morning, my dear students, and a very warm welcome to all of you in this e-learning program that is organized by Shri Gyanmanchi Vidyapeeth. Welcome to Science by Harsha Ma'am. In our today's session, we are going to talk about the production of anhydrous. Before we study about the production of anhydrous, let us have a quick look at what part we did for the production of cathodrase. How did the formation of cathodrase took place now? In an electric discharge tube at a very low temperature. Very low pressure, that is, when high voltage is applied, at that time beam of electrons was seen. Sir J.J. Thomson, Crookes and their all colleagues. They then finally came to the conclusion that actually current is flow of electrons when they saw very fine particles going from negative terminal of the battery towards the positive terminal of the battery. Okay, try to recall, this is how the arrangement was. Just a moment. Okay. Here, anode and cathode was arranged, and over here, high voltage of about 10,000 volt was applied. Okay, and from here vacuum was created. On applying the high voltage, it was observed that all the electrons will go from the negative terminal of the battery towards the positive terminal of the battery. This is how it was seen that all the beam of electrons are going towards the anode. And this is how Sir J.J. Thomson and his all colleagues, they gave this whole concept. Another very important thing is we discussed about it was the Millikan soil drop experiment, which is used to find the E by M ratio. After that, the next important thing was the properties of the cathode rays. The very first one was they travel in the straight line. If at all any particular object is kept in between of their path, then their shadow will form. That means they travel in the straight line. Then a mechanical pedal, when it was kept, its shadow was it started moving when the beam of electrons started flowing. That means it is producing mechanical effect. The next very important thing is the rays are negatively charged. That is when we are producing the external field at that time, we are able to see that all the rays will migrate towards the positive side of the external field. And this is how we got the information regarding the whole of the concept of cathode rays. Now in our today's experiment, we are going to see how of anode rays. So our today's concept is the production and the properties of anode rays. Now, how the production of anode rays took place? It was Goldstein who did all the experiments. Now how he carried out the whole of the experiment. For that, again, he also took an electric discharge tube. Okay, and here it's the vacuum pump. Now over here, this is cathode and this is anode. Okay. Now to this, high voltage is applied. here small of the gas molecules are filled. We are taking very small, in very small proportion we are taking the gas, and it is kept at the pressure of about 0.001 mm of mercury column. So very less amount of gas is filled inside it, and about, you know, so you can say the so less, the pressure of the gas will also be low because the number of molecules are less. And what is the reason that low pressure is there, that also we will discuss. But first let us fill this with gas. These are the gas particles which are uniformly spread, and very less amount of gas is taken. Now pressure over here is very low. This acts as cathode. This acts as anode. This will act as cathode. This will act as anode. These are wires for connection. This is high voltage supply. This is electric discharge tube. And this is how the whole of the arrangement is being done. Now what is actually happening, and how are anode rays produced? First of all, whenever high voltage is supplied, at that time what happens is all the electrons, where they will go, they will go, the electrons will start their flow from cathode to anode. Okay, is that clear? Suppose we indicate the electron by let us say, we have not used that color so that you avoid confusion, light blue color. This is how we will depict electrons. Okay, So when the flow of electron will start from here, then they will start going like this towards anode, because negative charge will get attracted towards the positive charge. Now what will happen, you know, whenever the electrons are going at that time, these electrons will collide with the gas particles which are present over here. When the electron will collide with the gas particles which are present over here, what will happen? A good thing will happen. What will happen? This gas molecules, they will lose one of their electron, and that electron will strike back towards the cathode. Here, whenever it is striking at that time, one of the electron will come out from the gas molecules and they will start moving over here in the opposite end, and here they will get collected. And because of that, a red glow is observed over here at the end of the cathode. Why is the red glow happening? Once again, I'll tell you. Red glow is happening because, first of all, what is happening? Gas molecules are there. Electrons are going. Electrons are getting getting collided. Then, after getting collided over there, the electrons will gush out in this direction, that electron. And in this way, at the end of the cathode, the red glow will be. One more important thing. They will be able to move because this cathode ray is kept as a perforated cathode ray tube. Perforated means having some, like, any other kana hoy nana nana. Okay? And this is how the whole of the arrangement is there. Okay? I hope you are clear with the diagram as well as the concept, what the Goldstein did. Once again, let me explain you the whole of the concept. What was done by Goldstein? He took an electric discharge tube, then he filled the electric discharge tube with some of the gas molecules. After filling it with the gas molecules, what he did was he applied high voltage and removed all the air from it. Then the gas which was filled was at very low pressure, that is of about 0.001 mm of the mercury column. At the two ends, we are having the cathode and the anode. This cathode is perforated. Now when this amount of high voltage, that is of about 10 kV, it is supplied at that time, all the electrons will gush from cathode to anode. What will happen? The gas molecules, when they collide with this, they will lose their one electron, and this electron will gush out again over here, and we will be able to see the red glow towards the cathode. This is about the explanation, and I'm going to make you write the explanation. Till the time, just please note down this particular diagram. The diagram is very important over here because you have all the concepts, so you can write the whole of the answer. So please note it. Quickly note it down. Be quick. I hope you have noted down the diagram. Now let us write about the concept. In this experiment, an electric discharge tube was taken. It was filled with gas molecules. It was filled with the gas molecules at a very low pressure. That is, (0.001 mmHg). Now when the cathode rays, when the very high voltage of about 10,000 volt was supplied red glow was observed. Behind perforated cathode, okay. Now, how the formation of positive rays occurred? This is how it was produced. Now, about the formation of the positive rays. How these positive rays are formed now? When the electron, okay, whenever the electron will strike with the atom, at that time, what will happen? The atom will lose the electron, and once the atom is losing the electron, what will its charge become? Positive. Okay? So here, whenever these molecules, they will lose the electron, what will they form? They will form positive ions. And what will be positive attracted to? The negative. And this is how the formation of anode rays take place. Okay, this is how they will move. When the gas atoms, they are filled with the discharge tube, they will strike with the electron and they will lose the electron and they will form the positive ion. And this ion, this positively charged ions, will migrate to cathode okay. So suppose it is hydrogen, and so it will lose its electron, it will become a positively charged ion. And where this positively charged ion will move? It will move towards the cathode. So this is about its explanation. Okay, first note down its production quickly. This then will move further. Be quick. Now next part, note it, now Let's move further. What is the effect of low pressure? Why are we keeping the pressure so low as 0.001 mm? Now, if the pressure would be high, what will happen? If the pressure is high, then in that case, all the gas molecules will collide with the electrons and they will not allow the cathode ray only to form. Okay, they will constantly collide with the electrons and they will not allow this formation of cathode rays, which is actually responsible for the anode rays. Okay, we need voltage, we need the formation of cathode rays so that they will strike with the atoms. But whenever at atmospheric pressure, that is at high pressure as compared to what it is given over here, when the amount of pressure will be more, the gas molecule constantly collide with the electron. Okay, at high pressure, at atmospheric pressure, the gas molecules will collide with electrons and do not allow the formation of cathode rays. Thus, at low pressure is needed for the formation of anode rays. Now let us move on to the next particular topic, which is the properties of anode rays. All the properties of anode rays are somewhat similar, concepts are similar as we did of cathode rays. The very first property is the travel in straight line. Where will they travel in? Straight line. Okay, they will constantly move in one line. That means if you are keeping any object, then we'll get its shadow on the next side. So travel in straight line. Next is they produce mechanical effect. That is the next particular fact. Now, how will they produce the mechanical effect? They will produce the mechanical effect whenever a lightweight fan is kept in between of the rays, then that fan will start its motion, and this is how we can start a mechanical effect. Try to recall the same concept we have done for cathode rays. There we had drawn the diagram and we had learned the concepts. Now next property is they are positively charged. These are positively charged rays because what can we come to know now? Whenever we are producing the external field at that time, all the ions will move towards the negative terminal, and this is how we can conclude that they travel in the straight line and they are positively charged when all of them will be migrating towards the negative terminal. So please first note down this concept, effect of low pressure, then the next one, and finally we'll conclude with some of the statistical data. I hope you have noted it down. Next, one more property we need to add, that is the property of anode ray. Let me be more precise, the nature of the anode rays. Depends on the gas filled in the tube. Now, why does this happen? This happens because E by M ratio for different gases is different. That is, all the gases are having different electric charge, and some of the gases are having their own mass. We are knowing, and so E by M ratio is not constant for all the gases, and so even for the positive rays E by M ratio is not constant. And for hydrogen, this is important point. For hydrogen, E by M ratio is the lightest. The value of E by M for the hydrogen is the highest one. Okay? So these are the important points regarding the properties. Please note it down, then we'll see the last part, that is the charge on the proton and the total electric charge and the mass of the proton. These two things are left out. Please note down this, then we'll see that. Next part, which is the characteristics of anode rays or proton. If we talk about its mass, then its mass is, we need to memorize this, it's 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. As compared to electron, it is 1837 times heavier. And after that, we have the next fact about its charge. Charge on it is plus 1.6. Into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. This much is the charge on it, okay? And we take the reference as plus 1 charge. So these are important properties about the characteristics of proton. Down this quick. And with this, we conclude with today's session. I hope you have understood all the concepts that have been taught to you. And today we did about whole of the anode rays. Okay? This is the one. Electric discharge tube, the gas is filled in it. High voltage is supplied. Then when the high voltage is supplied, what will happen? The gas will lose its electron, and then all this positively charged ions, they will migrate towards the cathode. This cathode is perforated tube and a closed absorbed behind the cathode, and this is how the whole of the concept of the anode race is taking place. And that is all for today's content. Thank you so much for listening to me and have a very good day. Bye.